What's up, YouTube world? I'm Midnight. I'm your host for another installment of Interviews on 2. And today we have a gentleman from all the way down under. Definitely looks hardcore to me. I mean, you guys decide on that one. But I think when he goes to the club, I bet you this guy gets all the ladies. I love watching his videos. He's always out on some twisties, always out in the country somewhere. And he brings a unique look to his channel. Very inspirational guy. He's definitely highly creative and always into something new. Let's bring in NinjaRobDog. And looks like he's sitting out somewhere. Possibly, maybe near where I am in another country. So, Ninja, what's going on, man? How are you doing today? You doing pretty good?
What's up, my ninjas? G'day, Midnight. Glad you can make it down to Australia.
Well, I wish
as the locals say, Australia. Australia with a capital S. I just thought I'd drag you out into our beautiful countryside. It's a nice sunny day, so why not? It's better than better than inside a garage. My garage is messy anyway, so.
Hey, aren't they all?
Hope you enjoy the trees.
Well, it definitely looks good. Let's get this started. So, what got you into riding? What inspired you to hop on a bike?
Well, it wasn't so much an inspiration. It was out of necessity. I was riding a little scooter at the time. I loved that, and I was running around like that, and I, at the time I only had my car license, so one day she got pulled over by a cop, and he actually informed me that I wasn't supposed to ride the bike that I was on my car license. Well, yes, you can imagine my surprise, I was a little taken back by it, but that kind of gave me the push to actually ride, to go and get my license and ride motorcycles, because I think it's like 2 weeks after that I'd gone for my license, and a week after that I bought my 250 Ninja, so I was back. I love every second of it. I don't know why I never ever got into it earlier. I love it now. I couldn't imagine my life without it.
I think we're all in love with riding, but what do you do when you're not riding? What does NinjaRobDog do in his free time?
When I'm not riding, I'm editing videos.
Good.
Sleeping. into my music or DJing or doing something with my graphic design. So I've always got my fingers in something creatively. That's right. Didn't want to make that sound rude. I'm either working on videos, doing music, or doing my graphic design, so I've always got something on the go.
Well, that's good. You always got something going on. At least you're a busy guy. But what's your best characteristic? What do you think it is?
My best characteristic? Other than my good looks?
Ah!
Oh, shit. Man, that's a tough one. Creative? Is that a characteristic?
It could be.
Creative by nature?
Why not?
I've always got to, when I do something, either do it at that same level or go better. And I try to kind of better myself every time I do some trans with my videos. Every time I do a video, hopefully it gets better every time I do one. I think it does, but then I don't say it gets a lot better, maybe a little bit better. You know, I might try something different.
I noticed them.
Occasionally I'll do something and you'll see it in my next video, and then if I like that, I'll keep it and do it in my next video. Things like that. Even when it's not videos, if I'm working on my DJing, I always try to find different ways or blend in the music, you know, stuff like that. I'd say that was my best characteristic. It's my creativity.
Well, that's definitely a good characteristic to have. You know, some of us are more creative than others, but who were your role models growing up as you were a kid, and who are they today?
My role models growing up,
got to win a good thing, doesn't it?
My role models, that's...
problem.
He gets me right up here. Anyway, to the subject. My role models. When I was younger, it wouldn't be so much their how they kind of held themselves, you know what I mean, but more what they've done.
Yeah.
If it was music, Michael Jackson was probably one of my biggest influences growing up. Not only for his music, but for his videos. He changed the whole way how music videos started to come out. When I was in my teens, I was big into skateboarding. So obviously my role models there were Tony Hawk, Steve Caballero, Mike McGill. Now they're all from the Bones Brigade.
Yeah.
One year I got the pleasure of actually meeting and skating with Tony Hawk, and that was awesome. Blew my mind.
I bet it was.
What about my role models now? Oh my god. I suppose not so much role models, but guys that inspire me, especially with now making vlogs. I watch Nicknames videos. Always good, always clean. Mm-hmm. Nice kind of graphic elements to it. Rocket 44 is the same.
I love him.
Those guys always inspire me to do better work.
Great videos.
Wow, yes. So many. We could be here all day. I've been desperate enough for people to have this family, so. Those are just a couple of people that I know.
Yeah. Well, still, those are some good ones.
Look up to or inspire me the same.
Yeah. All right. What's your dream bike? What would you love to have right now?
My dream bike. Now, you're talking about this month, right? You're talking about this month's
yeah.
dream bike.
Yeah, next month too.
I have a dream bike, you know, almost every week. But the flavor of the month is the new 2012 R1, the matte black. I just love to do it.
Beautiful bike.
Whoa. If I was to upgrade right now, that's probably the bike I would go for. Bikes in the past, like the Z1000, and he's just out. Mm-hmm. Not a big fan of the whole Zorro on the side, but I like that for a naked bite. That was kind of high on my list as well. What are the other ones? Daytona 675,
yeah.
R6, yeah, but those are the bikes that I've, you know, liked in the past. I still like now. No doubt that I would test ride some of these bikes when I upgrade. I'm looking forward to that. Although I do love my Ninja 250. I don't think I could ever let this bike go. I'll probably never sell it.
I won't with this one.
I'd keep it, rebuild it, give it to my little girl when she grows up. I'm sure her mother wouldn't like that at all.
But, probably not.
My dream bike of it right now is the 2012 Yamaha R1.
All right, well, Ninja Rob Dog, I do appreciate you taking the time out to do this, and I look forward to seeing your next video. Always improving, always doing better each time, and I thoroughly enjoy the whole process, and I appreciate it.
Yeah, well, thanks, but not. It was great doing this this interview. It feels kind of odd doing an interview. But I hope you guys enjoyed it. I enjoyed doing it. Hopefully we'll see you next time. Keep watching my videos.
As always.
Subscribe. Do all that sort of thing. And stay rubber side down, guys.
All right, I will. And you do the same. And I will see you later.
Thanks again. Thanks again, Midnight.
All right, guys, that was Ninja Rob Dog, and as you can see, he's quite a pretty laid-back kind of guy, and I enjoyed talking with him in conjunction with doing the interview. Absolutely loved everything about it, and definitely look forward to seeing his next video. I can't wait to see it. So until next time, which I believe I have another interview coming up. I think I do. And let's see if you guys can guess who it is. Name starts with an I. But like I said, until next time, I am Midnight. This is the Interview on 2. And I will see you.